In this lesson, we're going to look at how we can replace components in an Autodesk Inventor assembly. Here I have an assembly with several different circular features added onto these pegs, and I want to replace one of them with a similar shape. To do so, I'll simply right-click on it in the model tree, then I will point to Component, then Replace. Then I can select the component I want to replace it with. I'll select the component, then click Open. If the component is very similar to the original one, the constraints should update and it should assemble the new part just the same as the old one. We can also replace several different components at once. If I wanted to replace every one of these shapes, I can once again right-click on one of these components, point to Component, then this time Replace All. Then I can select the component that I want to replace them with, in this case the spacer, then Open, and once again, since they're all very similar parts, they are all completely constrained and updated. Let's see what happens if we replace a component with a different shape. Once again, I'll right-click on one of these components and point to Component, then Replace. Then I will select a different component to bring in. In this case, I'll select this square shape instead. Now they both have circular holes, but the overall shape is different. So I'll click Open and I get a little message indicating that I might lose some relationships. I'll go ahead and click OK. And I get a little error message here because again, that part is different enough that it doesn't really know what to do with it. So I could approach this a couple of different ways. I can go in here and delete the constraint and recreate it, or I can right-click on the constraint and select Recover. I'll go ahead and select the problem here, then click Next. It just tells me that the relationship was placed with geometry that's no longer available. So I'll select Next and then edit the relationship, then Finish. So I can see we have an insert constraint. I can see the one part is highlighted correctly. I just need to select the appropriate part on the other component. And now my assembly is updated. So once again, you can replace a single component, several components. If you replace it with a different type of part, then you might have to modify the constraints. That concludes this look at replacing assembly components in Autodesk Inventor.